in now for believers, harvest season.
Come on.
It's very important to a believer because this is when the seeds that you think God has forgotten that you sown,
come on now.
He brings them up.
Yes.
Without, he brings them up without you even thinking about it. It comes out of nowhere.
Come on.
The thing that you thought, that seed you sown in July, that sacrifice, you thought God forgot about it.
Come on, sir.
Comes out of nowhere when your bills are due and you're looking for an extra $300 and you're not understanding how you're going to pay it, but then someone calls you and says, come pick up a check.
Come on.
Yeah.
It's harvest season. And the funny thing about winter for a believer is the renewal, because in the winter the ground freezes.
Uh-huh.
It renews the ground.
Come on, sir.
The cold and the ice moist your soul. So then that's why the New Year's always in the winter, because you're redoing the same thing.
Come on, sir. Teach.
So in this particular season, you have to have two things to get this very particular harvest. One is faith.
Okay,
come on, man.
The Bible says, Hebrews 11:6, that without faith it's impossible to please God. You have to please him. So to please God, I don't care how good you sing, I don't care how good you pray, you have to have faith.
That's right.
Faith. Faith is believing in something that you don't understand why, but you see it. You got to see it before you actually have it.
Right.
Your harvest is growing right there, but if you don't see it yourself, you'll never get it.
Come on.
Right.
You have to have faith that my blessing is there, but I don't see it, I'm walking to it. And for the believer, the other part to get your blessing is prayers. See, faith moves God.
Come on.
It moves him. He loves him.
Yes,
when you pray and releasing your faith, it moves God.
That's right.
But your praise releases his hand.
Come on. Come on.
There. Well, you got the camera. Tasha, I'm going to use. Tasha's been praying for a car. She wants a new car. She wants like an SUV.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Tasha's been praying and releasing her faith for it. She got a picture and she put it on the wall and she thanked God every day for it.
Uh-huh.
So then Tasha came to church Sunday.
Come on. Teach, sir.
After the complete food, just praising the Lord.
Uh-huh.
Y'all sat there like y'all were doing.
Exactly. Yes.
But Tasha was still praising. So God said, I saw the faith that moved.
Yes, sir.
God said, now wait, she's praising him. So God went like this to give her car.
Right. That's
it releases. See,
come on,
praise
see.
Is an action.
Right.
With every action, there's a reaction.
Yeah.
Y'all don't hear me.
Come on.
With every action, there's a reaction. So with every action, if you hit somebody, they're going to hit you back. If you praise God, God's going to say, I saw it. I feel it. I'm going to give it to you now. So praise is important.
Come on, man.
Can't come. A lot of times our praise is affected by the outside.
That's true.
We're all human, we're all flesh.
That's right.
Things going on in our life this week, be honest with you.
That's right.
Found out some things about me, health wise. Then the same day I found something about my father. And he's in the hospital right now. So I didn't want to particularly come and do that. We'll call pastors and pastors.
Can I
get a rent check? Can I do it at the end of the month or something?
I wish you would.
But pastor, I start praying and my assignment is here because the message spoke to me. It helped me when I wasn't sleeping. So I had to read, and I kept reading, and I had to realize that my praise was going to bring me out of my dad's sickness and my sickness.
Come on.
Your blessing is right there, and it seems like all hell breaks loose
right
when
there.
You're just this close to getting
it. Come on.
When it's in reaching distance, everything starts happening.
Come
but
on.
It's the reason for everything.
Yes, sir.
Everything that happens to you works for your good.
Come on, yes, sir.
That's
never for your bad.
Yes, sir.
So your praise is going to actually release that blessing that is right there. Now God's going to move it just an inch closer to you, but you're just going to pull it.
Yes, sir.
Come on.
See, interesting text. David brought the ark of God to the city of David. The New Living Translation said he gathered 30,000 of elite men. He was bringing it from the house of Obadiah to the city of David.
Uh-huh.
And I was reading it in the 13th verse. Kind of touched me a little bit. And it says, and so that when they had bear the ark of God, of the Lord, and gone 6 paces, he sacrificed an oxen and flattened, and that's a calf. And I wonder why they went 6. Why 6? Because it was a celebration. David bought it with gladness. It was a celebration. He wanted to bless the city of David. Why 6?
Mm-hmm.
So I asked the Lord, why 6? The Lord said, if they had went 7, it would have been completed. It would have stopped. The job's done. But they said, I don't want to go any further. I'm going to take 6 steps. I don't want to go any further. I don't want to lose this feeling.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of times our praise, we cut it off a little too short. Because we think we're taking up time.
That's right.
I was happy when I saw Dana.
Yes.
Kept going.
Right.
A lot of the time we think about the watch too much.
Mm-hmm. Yes, sir.
We think about the football game.
Yes, sir.
We think about house bars of whatever. Let's be real. We think about food. So we want to get out of church. We want to come to church, run good motions, and leave. But you don't understand what that one praise could have broke for her.
Come on.
That one praise could have been a breakthrough that she needed.
Yes.
And instead of looking, what should have happened, everyone should have been praying her for.
Yes.
Come on now.
Okay.
Come on.
So we are here, and David is gone 6 paces, and David danced before the Lord with all his might. With all his might. No matter what, David danced before the Lord with all his might.
Yes, sir.
And the reason why he did, he had an expectation. First point is expecting God to move.
Uh-huh.
You have to praise God with an expectation.
Right.
You have to praise God with God's going to handle whatever thing that's outside of these four walls that was bothering me.
Right.
And when I leave here, after I praise the Lord, God's going to make a way for me.
Come on. Come on.
You have to have a praise of expectation.
Yes.
Somebody said expectation.
Expectation.
So David danced for the Lord, and he was dancing all his might. He was expecting God to bless the city of David. Then David is taken to set up a tent for his special tent for this ark of the Lord.
Okay.
He went and blessed every household in his city.
Uh-huh.
Because when God starts blessing you, you want to bless everybody else.
Come on.
And it's like, I'm praying. See, Pastor said one time, I was listening, he said, praise is, it's like fire. You stand too close, you'll get burned. That's like if Tammy starts praising the Lord over there. It's going to hit Malaysia. It's going to hit Sean. It's going to go down here, everybody back over there. It's going to hit Tasha, Miss Ann, First Lady. It's going to hit everybody because it's contagious. You want to praise the Lord with everybody. Because when 2 or 3 gather in his name, the Lord's in the mix. So you want to praise the Lord with everybody.
Right. Uh-huh.
But everybody ain't going to be happy that you're praising
that's
the Lord.
That's right.
That's right.
The closest people that are around you aren't going to be happy
that's right.
that you're praising the Lord.